is the first version of the AllRocket Avionics Bay or Air flight computer. The processor for this computer is the Arduino Nano Every. It has enough processing power for what it has to do, but on future versions I'll use the Raspberry Pi Pico W. It's far more powerful, much cheaper, and allows for Bluetooth capability. I will have to make some changes to the design, for the Raspberry Pi Pico is larger and lacks an EEE prom. The Arduino Nano Every probably only has enough processing power for TVC controls and not landing, but that's all I'm using this version for. Having Bluetooth on a Raspberry Pi Pico will allow for connectivity to an app, which would be very useful for a rocket that has to land. The computer has a bunch of outputs, so I'll get to explaining them to you. The board has two 3 long header pin lines for two server motors. These server motors will be used for the TVC mount. There's another line of header pins, this time only 2 long for the DC motor. These lines are connected to an L293D so that the motor has multidirectional control. The motor controls and powers the reaction wheel if I'll ever use one. The computer also has a red LED and a buzzer to alert me visually or by sound. The computer only has one power channel that can switch on 12 volts, so I can only have one in-flight event. I'll basically only use this for a parachute. I don't even know if this can be considered an output, but it has a flash chip to log in flight data, and then it also has a microSD card that it sends the data to after the flight is over for my easy access. I don't know if it can really be considered an input, but I'll give it my best shot. Starting off with sensors, it has the MPU6050 GBAP521, an inertial measurement unit that doesn't have a built-in Kelvin filter. To measure its altitude, it will use a barometer, and the barometer it's using is the BMP280. The computer has a small circuit that regulates the 12 volts from the battery to 5 volts to be used by the breakout boards. The computer can still use the 12 volts though. There's also a voltage divider that the computer uses to monitor the battery percentage in a way. The computer turns on by bridging a terminal block in the regulation circuit. This also arms the power channels. I didn't use a separate terminal block to arm the power channels, so tell me in the comments if I should change that before I shove this computer in a rocket. Okay. I'll talk a little bit about the dimensions for the few people that are still watching. It's 4 inches long, 3 inches wide, and 0.8 inches tall when laid flat. It's also 71 grams. Yeah, not light, but later versions will be on a PCB and therefore lighter. But anyways, that concludes today's video, and thanks for watching. Hey, I put a lot of time and effort into making these videos, and I'm really trying to grow this channel, so if you enjoyed, please leave a like.